Welcome to EnviroMed Design Group's Dreaming Into Reality Dental Office Design course. We're glad you chose to spend some time with us. If you're watching this video, it is most likely because you are contemplating one of the most significant and ambitious undertakings of your career, building your dream dental office. Whether you're building from ground up, finishing out an interior space, expanding or remodeling your current space, this video has information that will be helpful for you. Our goal is to provide you with information in a chronological order to make this journey as cost-effective, stress-free, and as fun as possible.
There are several key questions you need to answer before any planning begins. The first is, what is your exit strategy? How much longer do you want to practice in the new facility? These questions might help you determine if you should lease or build something from the ground up.
Efficiency is acting effectively with a minimum of waste. This is important in design, especially in areas where square footage is minimal. If you're lucky and have ample space to design within, you still want your design to be efficient and functional.
Soil borings. If you're doing a new building, two more words. Do them. They're cheap insurance. They'll cost you probably $3,000. You'll find out what's under the ground, if you have water table, what kind of bearing capacity you have. If you're in an area full of rock, you probably don't need it, but any place where there's soil, dirt if you want to call it that, do your borings, and here's a reason why. Here's somebody that said, gee, I don't think I need soil borings, but look, you know, this is 4 feet down, and there's water that had to be pumped throughout the entire project.
Storage. In most offices, the old adage of you can never have enough storage is generally true. So as you lay out all the functionality of the office, trying to get in everything you need for your practice, be sure and plan in the storage as well.
There are so many types of finished materials out there, and with all of these options, how do you know which is best for your office? We're going to go over a few of these big questions today. As you get more involved with your project, be sure to work with your professional team, and they will also be able to help guide you through some of the other major details.
This is an office on their first opening day. Would you be happy with this? Look at all of this technology back here. We have three computers, we have four credit card machines, we have a printer, we have a stereo, we have a phone, a couple of battery backups. This was actually designed to be used as a business space for somebody when the office was growing with their clientele to be able to put an additional employee in this space. But now this space has been taken up by all of the technology that should be, for the most part, hidden.